Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK and welcome to another episode of DGN. Dagan's guitar news here on the PMT House of Rock YouTube channel, a weekly news roundup show where we chat about all the awesome new gear that's landed this past week and what's happening in the world that's rocking and rolling around us. Here's what's coming up this week. It's the start of the year, January 2022. It's when the NAMM show probably should have been if COVID wasn't a thing, but it's happening in June this year. But that hasn't stopped some of our favourite brands from releasing new gear for 2022, because you need to start the year off with a bang, don't you? And Fender have started out with one hell of a bang. We have some amazing new gear from the fine folk at Fender Musical Instruments Corporation, from pedals, anniversary guitars, expanded lineups, brand new guitars, as well as a myriad of beautiful new colours and finishes. We'll be talking about that. Epiphone have launched the new Joan Jett signature guitar and it's absolutely kick-ass. And Gibson have released a signature Mike Ness gold top and it's bloody beautiful. And in the world of music, the famous mural behind Hollywood's guitar center of our Lord and Savior, Edward Van Halen, has been animated and you can check it out with augmented reality and it's absolutely crackers. And finally ending with, this is a really intense bit of news. Bryan Adams has revealed his first real six string that he bought at the Five and Dime. Right, let's get into it. Let's talk about some cool new Fenders, shall we? So there's loads of gear from Fender that's just been released, so I'm going to split it up throughout this video. I'm just going to dump loads of Fender on you right now. The first things I want to talk about, though, are the new JV guitars. Now, this is a nod back to the Japanese reissues from the 80s, where Fender first dipped their toe into modifying these classic designs, these iconic Fender Strats and Telecaster designs, with some modern attributes and making them a bit more funky and futuristic. They're now back. Just like the originals from the 80s, these four reissued models are also made in Japan. There's a 50s Strat with a HSS configuration, so a humbucker on the bridge, 60s Strat, 50s Tele, and a 60s Custom Tele. They all feature some very funky, unique wiring as well, which is awesome, but the main difference is kind of lying under the hood of these guitars. They just look like highly specced Fenders. They look fantastic, but they've got basswood bodies, which is a really peculiar tone wood for Fender. They never really use basswood. It's either alder or ash. But yeah, basswood bodies on these guitars. And the necks are thick V profile. So it's a satin maple neck. So they're not gloss. It's a thick V profile. If you've never played a V profile neck, it can be quite peculiar. It's a bit alien a little bit, but they do feel comfy. It takes a bit of getting used to. Eric Johnson has a V-shaped profile. Old school like resonator guitars have a V-shaped profile. They're quite funky. It's a 9.5-inch radius fretboard as well. Medium jumbo frets. Yeah, a cool new lineup from Fender. Taking hints from the original 80s ones. Awesome. The new JV range. I can't wait to get my hands on them. Next up, let's talk about Epiphone. Epiphone and Gibson have been absolutely killing it this past year, and they continue to kill it into 2022 with the new Joan Jett Olympic Special. Now, Joan Jett is one of my favourite... Well, the Runaways are amazing, and Joan Jett and the Blackhearts are just amazing. She's got one of the most iconic voices, not only in rock, but in music. And she's known for rocking her heavily stick-it-up Gibson Melody Maker, which has taken a battering over the years, hasn't it? There's been a couple of different versions of this guitar over the years with Gibson in the custom shop, but now a more affordable version has came out with the Epiphone Joan Jett Olympic Special. Now this guitar, the Melody Maker back in the day, was a more affordable Gibson guitar, just like the Les Paul Jr. was, the Double Cut Juniors and all that kind of jazz. So it's nice to see an Epiphone one back. And the way Epiphone are going at the minute, Gibson and Epiphone are very, very close quality. Gibson are amazing, Epiphone are just absolutely knocking out the park. So this single pickup, rock and roll machine, which comes with stickers, I must add, I reckon is gonna sell like absolute hotcakes, and it's a 92% sure that I'm gonna get one for myself as well. This guitar is a super simple, stripped back rock and roll machine. Mahogany body, set mahogany neck, Laurel fingerboard, 22 frets, a Power Hammer Pro humbucker, just the one. It's all you need to play Joan Jett and the Blackheart stuff or Runaway stuff. Absolutely, this guitar is the kind of thing where the harder you hit it, the better it will sound, I guarantee. No pickup selector because there's only one pickup, but the little switch on it is a kill switch. It's a 500k CTS pot, so some of the best stuff on the planet. And yeah, like I say, it comes with all the stickers, so you can really, really ramp it up. It's got a wraparound tailpiece, all the hardware is nickel, and it's got that signature headstock as well. They should be landing very, very soon, and there's going to be reviews as soon as I get my hands on one. And yeah, like I say, I'm probably going to get one. So if you want to get one as well, linked in the description box down below is where you can pre-order this and pretty much everything else I talk about in today's video. Now let's get back to Fender and talk about some stunning anniversary guitars. It's quite a special year for Fender this year. So 2022 marks the 60th anniversary of the Jaguar. Released in 1962 onto the world, this guitar has graced so many legendary tunes over the years. Rock songs, pop songs, blues songs, jazz songs, surf songs. You can do a lot with the Jaguar and its wonderful 24-inch scale. To celebrate 60 years of the Jaguar, they're releasing a few beautiful limited edition guitars. The first couple, Mystic Dakota Red and Mystic Lake Placid Blue. They're kind of like a more luxurious version of the Jaguar we're all accustomed to, and it's very fancy to celebrate this anniversary. But the third is the Ultra Lux. So it's 25.5-inch scale, two humbuckers, kind of like a modern Jaguar. I think they're absolutely amazing. So three new guitars for the 60th anniversary of the Jaguar. Let me know which one your favorite is down below in the comments. I like the Mystic Dakota Red one, but also I dig that 25.5-inch scale humbucker one too. It's always the same when you work in music stores, when companies release these anniversary guitars and they don't necessarily change them massively. Like they don't put like a Floyd Rose on and make them solid gold or something. It's like, why am I paying a premium for that guitar? It's just the same as a regular Jaguar. There's only one 60th anniversary. So these guitars are limited edition, obviously, but very special guitars to mark a landmark. And speaking of landmarks, Squier, Fender's sister company, it's 40th anniversary for them. So 40 years ago in 1982, which I can't believe was 40 years ago, 10 years older than me, they released the Squier brand onto the world. Fender, they're more affordable, like correct, none of this dodgy kind of almost a Fender, not a Fender. Fender guitars under the Squier name, cheaper 40 years ago. And to celebrate, they're releasing some just as beautiful models of some of these iconic guitars. Strats, Tellies, Basses and Jazzmasters. I can't forget Jazzmasters. So there's P-Basses, Jazz Basses, Jazzmasters, Strats and Tellies. There's 10 models in total. Gold edition, kind of beautiful, special guitars, and they look absolutely stunning. Again, they are on paper just Strats and Tellies, but there's a lot that goes into 40 years of this brand, and they're cool limited editions to have. And they look fantastic, whether you want to have it on the wall above your fireplace or play it, because Squier are some of the best playing affordable guitars on the planet right now, and now you can look as good as you feel with some Sherwood green, gold, pickguard, telly, and some of the basses look awesome as well. All the fingerboards are bound. They've all got our Nico pickups in. Bravo, Squier, a great addition. Well, a great tribute. Celebration, a great celebration for 40 years under the Fender name. Awesome guitars. Just to make it clear as well, because I think I was harping on a bit too much there, there's a gold edition and vintage edition. The gold have all the gold appointments on, which I love, and the vintage editions have satin finishes with aged hardware. Two cool examples to celebrate 40 years of Squier. Now let's stick with Fender for a second and talk about some wonderful new acoustics. Now I'm not much of an acoustic guitar player myself, but every time I have picked up one of the old Fender Paramount acoustics, I've loved it. Great playing, feeling and sounding guitars, and they don't cost an arm and a leg either. I know Meg from PMTVUK also loves the Paramount guitars as well. And now for 2022, they've expanded their lineup with some gorgeous new models. There's Dreadnoughts, Parlors, Resonators, and also a banjo and a mandolin, because why the devil not? I'm not much of an acoustic player, but I am partial to trying my hardest to play Sweet Child of Mine on a banjo, or trying to play the intro to Welcome to the Jungle, or whatever I can just to irritate everyone around me. But yes, they're all new Paramount from Fender, mandolins, banjos, parlors, resonators, dreadnoughts, new acoustic guitars from Fender. You probably see them around me right now, and in the description box. Next up, Gibson have released a signature Mike Ness Les Paul Deluxe, based off his beloved 1976 Les Paul Deluxe. This thing is just awesome. Mike Ness, lead singer, guitar player, songwriter for the punk band Social Distortion, an amazing band and an amazing guitar. This guitar is kind of legendary in itself. If you're into guitars, into old guitars, you will know the look of Mike Ness's Les Paul Deluxe, because it looks like an old gold top, but it's from the Nolan era. So they've done it correctly. So the Nolan era Les Pauls are the guitars made in the 70s when Gibson was under the Nolan, but it's a different story for this. But they have maple necks. So the guitar has a three-piece maple neck. It would have came with little mini humbuckers like you find in a Firebird, those kind of things, and Les Paul Deluxes. But they've been swapped out for P90s on that gold top, and it's worn in such a beautiful way. The headstock's perfect, the body's perfect. It's got the Claysmith cams, Mr. Horsepower, you know, the Woody Woodpecker. Dude, it's got Orange County, the I Voted sticker, the period correct bits and bobs and the knobs and stuff. It's just awesome. It's a great looking punk rock Les Paul gold top. And that's what I love about gold tops and Les Paul customs as well, for that matter. You will see gold tops and Les Paul customs in the hands of some beautiful jazzy blues artists playing them up here, and they will look like they belong there. You will also find them down the knees of punk rock artists, and you know what? they look like they belong there. And that's the case with this 1976 Les Paul Deluxe as well. Every little nuance on Mike's original 1976 Les Paul Deluxe has been replicated on this guitar. I do believe it might be a limited edition, and it is full on Murphy aged as well, so it is a top tier price-wise guitar, but it's wonderful nonetheless. I love this new Mike Ness signature 1976 Les Paul Deluxe by Gibson. Let me know what you think. Next up, guess what? Back to Fender, but let's talk about pedals. They just released the hammer tone pedals. Fender have been making pedals for years, and they're brilliant pedals. Some of them quite funky and quite digital and quite forward-thinking and quite modern. This is a lot more stripped back to the roots of pedal design, really. So there's 9 new pedals in this lineup, and let's just say off the bat, they're very affordable. I think they start at like £65 up to £75, £80. Again, all linked in that description box down below if you want to pre-order some. So there's 9 pedals, all the effects you'd think of off the bat. There's delays, reverbs, distortions, overdrives, fuzzes, and they've all got a very cool bare bones layout. So like anodized aluminium chassis, the inputs and outputs are on the top to save real estate on your pedal board, so you can have lots of them close together and just wire them up from the top. Very easily laid out as well. They're all color coordinated with the kind of pedal they are. Some of them have 4 controls to change 4 parameters. Some of them have 3 controls with little switches, like you can turn the modulation on the delay, you can put an octave on the fuzz. You can do a lot with these pedals, and they're not a lot of money. But with it being Fender, you know the quality is going to be amazing, and they're going to sound absolutely kick-ass. The actual pedals, I should say, are distortion, overdrive, delay, reverb, fuzz, metal, chorus, and space delay. Pre-order away if your heart feels like it, or if you feel like it, or any part of you feels like it. Now these are the last 2 little bits from Fender. They've released a new Poodle case. I just had to talk about this. I know it's just a case, but look at it. This is the case that the original 1954 Strats came in, and now it's been adopted for the modern era. You either put a Strat or a Tele in. That's usually the case with Fender cases. You either put a Strat or a Telecaster in. They're designed in that kind of way. And now you can get this classic 50s Poodle case, which does, I must say, have a little resemblance to Gibson Custom Shop cases, but that's what cases looked like back in the day. Whether it was Gibson or Fender or whatever, cases looked like this back in the 50s and the 60s, and now, well, a fancier hard cases did. Like when you buy 59 Les Pauls, you could probably get it in like a little zip bag. But if you wanted a fancy one, this is what cases looked like back in the day, and the Poodle case is back, and I think it's absolutely badass. Final thing with the Fender Musical Instruments Corporation, they have so many guitars under their umbrella, so like Charvel, Jackson, Gretsch, EVH. There's new models, finishes, variants available. There's more than ever 2022. So get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk and check out the new finishes. There's some chameleon finishes on some Charvels. There's some gold sparkle finishes on some EVHs. Satchel has a new white and black guitar. Jackson have a new concept series, like a high spec concept series. There's some slanted pickups on some Randy Rhodes guitars in the neck position. There's a lot going on in 2022. We'll be here all day if I keep talking about Fender, but I'm tired of talking about Fender. But I could talk about EVH for a bit. So yeah, this week would have been Eddie Van Halen's 67th birthday. Now, it's no lie that I am a huge Van Halen fan, and I wouldn't play guitar if it wasn't for Mr. Edward Van Halen. And when he passed away, 2019, what year is it again? Behind Guitar Center in Hollywood, there was a huge mural put up of Eddie playing the Frankenstrat, and it's just absolutely breathtaking to see. And to celebrate what would have been his 67th birthday, it's been animated through an augmented reality experience. Check it out. So if you're ever in Hollywood or the Los Angeles area, get yourself down Sunset Boulevard to Hollywood Guitar Center and check out the Long Live the King mural on the back of Guitar Center. It's absolutely epic. Here's what Roman had to say from the augmented reality company. Augmented reality technology is the next wave of experimental entertainment, and we make things people dream about really happen. The waves of Van Halen fans holding up their phones to the mural and tearing up watching Eddie play after his death, I have the best job in the world. This is what we like to hear. It's awesome. So this mural itself was revealed in 2021, this same time. So it was Eddie's birthday, which was January 26th, for his 66th birthday. This mural was revealed, and now a year later, it's animated with augmented reality. It was painted by Robert Vargas, who did it in 2 weeks. 2 weeks to paint this beautiful mural. And here's what he said this week about the whole thing. This is Hollywood, Sunset Strip, where the band made a name for themselves. I wanted to be able to celebrate that. They were famous all around the world, but this is home. If there was going to be an Eddie Van Halen mural that was going to be up there, I definitely had to be the one to do it. I wanted to do it bigger and larger than life, just like Eddie was. And can't celebrate that even more. Sunset Strip is one of my favorite places on the entire planet. It just oozes the era of music that I personally love, and all of my favorite bands are from that that area of the era of the early 80s to the late 80s, and yeah, this is an amazing mural, and now the fact augmented reality is a thing, I think it's badass. And last but certainly not least, the part of DGN you've all been waiting for. Bryan Adams has revealed the first real six string that he bought at the Five and Dime. Everyone knows Summer of 69. It's one of the most legendary tunes of all time. I play it pretty much every weekend at weddings and function events. And I've always been curious. What was your first real six string that you bought at the Five and Dime? And now he's revealed it. He didn't say it as a statement. This is the first guitar I bought. First real six string. No, he was talking, promoting his new album that's coming out. So Happy It Hurts. He spilled the beans and this is what he said. I bought an imitation Les Paul at a Five and Dime store in Ottawa, Canada in 1971. Before that, I had an imitation Strat, which I bought in Reading, England in 1970. So his timing's a bit off. He bought his first real six string in 1971, not actually 1979. And the fact that he owned an imitation Strat before he had his imitation Les Paul, which is the one he bought the Five and Dime, which means that he didn't really care much for his Strat, and the first real six string he bought was this fake Les Paul at a Five and Dime in Canada. Yeah, that's it. So yeah, he didn't actually buy in the summer of 69, which kind of breaks my heart a little bit, but yeah, his first real six string was an imitation Les Paul, and the reason he liked it so much, I felt at the time to have a Les Paul. Even though I'm a massive Richie Blackmore fan, still am, I was heavily into Humble Pies, rocking the Fillmore album at the time, and both Peter Frampton and Steve Marriott were on Les Pauls. It's rock guitar heaven, that album. So yeah, since then, he's played lots of genuine Les Pauls and genuine Stratocasters, but his first real guitar was a imitation Les Paul that he bought at a Five and Dime. With that as well, So Happy It Hurts is Bryan Adams' up-and-coming studio album, so keep an eye out for that. I'll be chatting about it on DGN when it finally comes out. Hopefully he might expand more of his musical gear journey on that album. Who knows? But let me know down below in the comments what you think of his first real six string or anything you've thought about this week's episode of DGN. Any of the taste in new Fender stuff, the new Joan Jett guitar, the new Mike Ness guitar, Eddie's amazing mural, as well as the first real six string. Let me know what you think down below in the comments, and everything is linked down there so you can pre-order stuff and check stuff out at the links provided. Have a good one, look after yourselves. Cheers, see you next week.